Hey pals, Dave here with a few tips about riding the trains in Japan. These are a little specific to taking trains from Kansai International Airport, KIX, but the concepts, as it were, should apply to most any trains. Now, the good news and the bad news is Japan has so many different options and choices and types and timetables and service types and all that about trains. So this, I'm going to try and make it as simple as possible. It's also worth noting that I'm hardly qualified to talk about this. I'm much more experienced at hitchhiking around Japan than I am with trains. So, anyway, you've arrived at Kansai Airport or any other airport, and for the most part, there's a station baked right into the airport. You'll see signs, obviously pointing you to a railway. Once you get there, it's a little hectic and chaotic, so take a moment to breathe, orient yourself, and and get ready for this next couple steps. Now, there's a few different ways to get your ticket. Some of you will have purchased a JR pass in advance. You have to do this with an agent in your country of choice, and they give you a voucher. And then you have to go somewhere to actually redeem the pass and turn it, well, redeem the voucher to make it into a pass. Usually, this is the longest line you'll see. There, every other line in Japan seems to be efficient and short. This one, however, is usually not. So look for the signs to the ticket office, and there'll be usually two lines. One to buy ad hoc tickets, especially for reserved or green car, which I'll get to later, tickets, and another line to redeem your passes. Technically, you're not supposed to take photos in these places, so this is illegal information. Anyway, when you redeem your voucher, you need to show your passport, which they'll look at studiously. So if you do buy a pass in advance, make sure the name on the voucher matches your passport exactly. I don't make the rules. Your second option for buying just ad hoc, one-at-a-time tickets is to go into the same ticket office. And remember I told you about the long line with all the foreigners lining up, waiting to redeem their pass. Then there'll be a line that's no line at all with many tellers usually available for your convenience. And they will sell you one-off tickets. Now, generally, this is only for if you're buying green car, which is the executive class, the business class tickets, or reserved seat tickets. If you're just buying a regular non-reserved seat, you're supposed to use the vending booths outside, but you know, you're a foreigner, you smile a lot, you act a little dumb, and they'll help you out. Because the vending machines themselves, while efficient in many ways, can be a little bit complicated. You're presented with a board with so many different buttons of so many different destinations, and it's a little bit much. So, for me, one, I prefer to spend the extra money to get the green car service. This gives you extra leg room, sure, but more importantly for me anyway, it's a little bit more chill and quiet and not so busy and hectic. If you have a JR pass, it's good for the non-reserved seats. So sometimes, especially on the busy trains, even the bullet trains, it's like rush standing room only. So if you can't deal with that, spend the extra money to get the reserved seat or the green car seat, each a step up from the regular non-reserved service. This isn't to dissuade you from using the vending machines if you're feeling a little crafty and want the experience. Plus, if you stand there with a quizzical look and a raised eyebrow, someone will probably come up and offer to lend you a hand. And since you'll have cash from the post office that you went to, based on the advice in the previous video, anyway, you'll figure it out. Sound good? All right, every one of the Shinkansen, or as we colloquially call them, bullet train, lines in Japan has a different name for the line, but then also different names for the various train services that run on that line. So you're inundated with too many names. But to make this easy, to go from Kansai, you'll take the Haruka train to Kyoto, although most of you will get off in Shin Osaka to switch trains. Now, as you'll see from this lovely image, there's now a special train designed like Kitty-chan. Hello Kitty train. There's links if you want to figure that out. The cool thing about it is there's like lounge cars in it, because most of the trains in Japan are just seats, right? And this gives you a little bit of a lounge area. Okay, all right, so you've gone into the ticket counter or up to the machine and you've purchased a ticket for Okayama. If you just go up to the desk and say Okayama, 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 they'll figure it out. And they'll send you a little handful of tickets. You'll end up with probably three slips of paper, depending on what you buy. One of them is probably an upgrade slip, if you do that. And then the other one is a ticket from Kansai to Shin Osaka. And then the next one is from Shin Osaka to Okayama. Now, you can ask them to write down the track number on that, or you just keep an eye out on the boards. There's boards everywhere, but again, it can get a little bit confusing, especially if you're a little haggard and spun out from several hours on an airplane, many hours on an airplane. So you've got your tickets in hand, and you go over to the turnstile. Now, to catch the train from Kansai, and again, this is going to be different at whatever airport, it's at gate B. And when you go through the turnstile, you'll see a little slot, and you put in all three, two or three of your little slips of paper, walk through the turnstile, and it spits them out somehow magically out the other end. I have no idea how they do this. I'm not an engineer. Now, if you have a JR pass, at the end of the turnstiles, there's a little ticket kiosk, and that's where you go through and it shows show your pass to them and walk on to go get your train. Now, the tricky part is figuring out the track number and where to stand and all this kind of stuff. And my best advice for you is to look at the signs and or have your ticket in hand and go to anyone with a uniform and say, "Doko desu ka? Doko desu ka?" Right? Which means, "Where is this? Where is this?" And this is kind of sloppy Japanese, but they'll point you in a direction. They'll either point you in a direction or blabber a whole bunch of Japanese to you that you won't understand, or in some cases, lead you there directly and see that you comfortably get on your train. Now, if you bought a reserved ticket rather than just using a non-reserved JR pass, it will have a specific car number and seat number on it. When you go to the platform, you're going to see numbers up ahead that should correspond with your train cars. The tricky part is different cars will have different train numbers depending on the different service coming on that track. So honestly, I've never really figured out exactly how this works, but do note that there's car numbers there, and then there's little pathways to line up because you got to line up orderly and whatnot. So this all sounds a little intimidating and confusing. Well, it is for me anyway. So great news is there's little kiosks everywhere where you can get yourself a snack and a beverage, pack of gum, whatever you pleases you. There's toilets everywhere, of course, push the buttons. So then you hop on your train, and again, in our use case from Kansai to Shin Osaka, it's a quick ride, maybe half an hour, if that. As you're on the train, you're constantly inundated with announcements in Japanese, Korean, Chinese, and English, telling you what stop is next, what side to get off, and all this kind of thing. So hang in there, because once you get to Shin Osaka, this is when your big power move comes. So you're on the train, you hear the announcement that our next station is Shin Osaka, and be ready, because these trains do not linger at the stops. Be ready by the door as best you can with your gear, and hop off the train, and again, get out of the way, pause for a moment, and look for the signs to Shinkansen. And you say, "Well, I'm already on a Shinkansen, aren't I?" No, no, just trust me on this. Follow the signs to Shinkansen. If you have a bunch of gear with you, it's worth looking for the signs for the elevator. I know I do. So you go down the elevator off the platform, and then you meander through this crazy station for a little bit. Whoa, my goodness gracious. All these people, all these shops. You'll see places that are serving lunch and signs and stuff and people in their way, and everyone's looking at their phone. Follow the signs to Shinkansen. You're going to have to zoom your ticket through the little ticket booth again. So have that handy. And then you're going to be then into that station, and you're going to see all the different choices for tracks. So again, look at your ticket, look at the board, figure out what train it is, and make your way to that track. There's an elevator to take you up to the platform, again, if you have a bunch of gear. Now, this is a little bit tricky, so if you find yourself a little bit confused, find a uniformed personnel and just show them your ticket and say, "Doko desu ka?" Get your ticket. Don't get intimidated. Don't get stressed out. Be ready for your stops. Ask for help. Make sure you have a beverage. And zoom, zoom, we'll see you in Okayama.